Hello, and thank you for watching. My name is Rachel Barnett with Gentle Frog. I'm here to create videos for you to help you understand QuickBooks slightly better than you currently do. If you have any comments, questions, or suggestions, please put them in the chat box. Thank you.
In this video, I'm going to show you how to take the receipt that you've uploaded via the mobile app and add it to your QuickBooks as an expense. So to get to your receipts, you want to go, the shortcut for me at least, is that I go to my bank transactions. This is where you typically have all those squares with your bank accounts. From here, I go to receipt. A different way to get here is to go to transactions and then down to receipt, and it'll take you directly here. I just find myself on the bank transaction screen all the time, so it's quicker to go to the receipts across the top. So I have two of the receipts. I paid for this using personal money. It's not connected to my QuickBooks. So you're not going to see the word match. What I do want to show you is that at no point did QuickBooks stop and say, you know what? That looks like a duplicate of something you've uploaded. Also, interestingly, it's decided that Canada Post is both inventory asset as well as cost of goods sold. It read Canada Post from the receipt, but somehow gave it two different descriptions, even though it's the same receipt. So I just want you to take a moment and just realize that the receipt function can be a little bit tricky. Let's work with the bottom one since it has information that it extracted. On the right-hand side of my screen, under the word action, I have the word review. But next to review, there's a dropdown. My two options are delete and find a match. I know I'm not going to find a match, and so I'm just going to click on review and see what my options are. This is my chance to review and update this information. This is assuming that I did not do this using the mobile app. So the payee, I'm just going to take a moment and say the description is Canada Post, but it doesn't know that the payee is Canada Post. So I'm going to make Canada Post. It's a vendor. Click on save. Where does the money come from? Doesn't matter because it didn't come from anywhere. The transaction date, it's smart enough to read it. Weird thing I discovered when moving to Canada, the dates are, the format is always different. Like, it's not consistent. So in this case, it was October 12th and they wrote it in a funny way, but QuickBooks is like, hey, we got this. I can add a memo if I want. So let's do a memo demo. The category, it's suggesting cost of goods sold. The category is really shipping. I don't have shipping. Do I have postage? Oh, my demo file doesn't have much of anything. Let's add postage. So expense, save under expenses, tax form doesn't matter, save. Okay, so the amount is $14.57. That's probably true. Oh, the real amount was $26, but $14 was the shipment or part of the shipment. It's a long receipt and I didn't take a picture of the whole thing. So I'm not faulting the software for not getting it right. Let's see here. There's no customer to link it to. There's no class to link it to. The reason that I'm doing this or the reason I'm looking at it is I had a client say, you know what? I want to add tags and I don't see a way to add tags. So I'm going to choose save and next. It says looks for potential matches. I don't have any. I'm going to create an expense. I'm like, all right, let's create an expense. An expense is now created. I can either click on reviewed, and then I have this most recent transaction, or, and what I'm way more likely to do, is click on the magnifying glass in the upper right-hand corner and go to the recent transactions. So I'll go to my Canada Post expense. So I don't care how you get here, just get here however you want, and then choose the tag that you want. This is labor intensive and not very fun, but it's what the client wants to do. They want to have tags on these things, and I wanted to show them how to do it. So in this case, I have this extra Canada Post. Let's just for fun, let's click on review. Let's see if it finds the other transaction. I want to know if it finds it and says, oh, that's a match. Demo 12, yep. I'm not even going to pick the right account. I just want to know if it's smart enough to find a match. Oh, 1457. No matches found. Okay, let's do search manually. I don't know why it's not searching the amount, because it knew it a second ago. Demo? Nothing? Match? No, it's not finding a match at all. Which is really stupid, because we know that there is a match because we just made it. So what I'll do really here is I'll just click on delete. I hope this video is helpful. I'm happy to make a couple of videos on the receipt function within QuickBooks. But with every video, you get my disclaimer that I do not like it. I find it extremely frustrating to use, and I strongly prefer not using it because of things like this. So please let me know if you have questions. Let me know if there's anything you want me to see if I can troubleshoot and create a sample for. Just because I don't do it doesn't mean that you don't and you shouldn't. I'm happy to brainstorm with you. All right, thanks.